a warm round of applause, please, for the magnificent Paul Alster.
Thank you. how the storm water slowed down the snow. I lost a conversation with myself in the very first thing. And the rest of my set will be in these colors, like fire. And as you probably saw in the program, it's dedicated to a person named David Voronovich. And for the dedications to make sense, I'd like to explain why that is like that. And the reason is, David Voronovich is a painter, photographer, filmmaker, and writer. And probably more than anybody else in the United States, he became the artistic voice of the radical wing of the fight against AIDS and ACT UP. And about a year ago, the Kronos Quartet asked me to write a piece for them. And not long after they asked me to do that, the governor of California vetoed a law that would have made it illegal to discriminate against gays and lesbians. I think he already had a law like this. And believe it or not, and even in San Francisco in 1993, we still don't have such a law. And so after the governor vetoed a law, several thousand of us went out and set fire to the California State Office building. I took my tape recorder and made a recording of what happened and transcribed the riot for the Kronos, and that became the String Quartet. And David was going to collaborate on the project with me, was going by the text. But he was very sick, and so there was, for months we waited for him to get better so he could get well enough to write the text. And he never got better, and then he died. And so after I finished the String Quartet, I decided I would write another piece, also using the riot material that would be for David. My little ritual to remember him by. So that's Burns on Fire. And that's what I'm doing right now. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.